Just more than 24 hours after a retired military veteran was shot and killed in the parking lot of a Metro Public Golf Course where he worked, police still have more questions than answers. And as News Channel 5's Emily Luxon explains, investigators hope someone watching will come forward with information that will help them solve this case.
It's just unusual for something like this to happen here.
It's been a quiet and somber day at the Shelby Golf Course in East Nashville. A memorial is a reminder of a popular employee who is missed by many.
He was just an easygoing guy, got along with everybody. Everybody loved him.
George Carpenter was doing what he loved, working as a facility attendant at the golf course when he was shot and killed. Now Metro Police are trying to find out why.
We don't know definitively what the motive was. We can't say it was robbery or anything else at this juncture. Everything is on the table.
Investigators do know the 71-year-old was shot beside his pickup truck in the golf course parking lot around 7 Sunday night. Colleagues heard gunshots and saw an unidentified vehicle slowly driving away. Carpenter still had his wallet and his truck was not damaged. Those who knew him best can't understand who would kill a man who was always hardworking, kind, and generous.
He's loaned golfers money. If they didn't have enough money to play the second round, he's been known to loan them money so they can play.
After canvassing the area in search of clues, police hope someone will come forward with information.
We're asking the community's help in this because it's typical that when someone commits such a crime as this, that they'll talk about it. And we're hoping that someone's heard this talk.
Because one tip could lead to a much-needed break in the case and provide answers to Carpenter's family and friends.
Please contact us with any and all information.
In East Nashville, Emily Luxon, News Channel 5.
And of course, if you might have any information on this case, call Crime Stoppers 615-74-CRIME. The golf course, by the way, will be closed until Wednesday morning.